Welcome again. 1.22, we take up to begin this particular session. And Twist to Store Bombay has a branch at Pune, and goods are generally invoiced to the branch at selling price being cost price plus 25%. The branch expenses, the branch keeps its own sales ledger and deposits all the cash received by it to the credit of the head office account located in Pune, and all expenses are paid by check from Bombay, and from the following details prepare branch account in the books of head office. So this is the question so far, and in this question, first of all, as usual, we have to pay attention to this particular fact that rate is based upon cost plus 25%. I need not require to tell you cost price plus margin is equal to invoice price. Rate is given on cost, so you will consider cost as 100, margin will be 25, invoice price will be 125. Your rate will be 25 by 125, so rate of loading on invoice price, that is 1/5. So opening stock is given, opening stock 75, closing stock 90,000, should not be a big problem. Similarly, opening and closing balance of debtors is given, goods invoiced from head office is given, rates and taxes is also given, and then sundry expenses 4,800, cash sales. Cash receipt from ledgers. Cash receipt from ledgers means cash receipt from debtors. Reason? Because under this particular system, only what we call one ledger, that is sales ledger, is maintained. And sales ledger is nothing but ledger of credit customers. So cash receipt from ledger balances means cash receipt from credit customer, that is cash receipt from debtors. We have been given credit sales also. Besides that, wages paid, and wages is still owing. Is still owing means till the accounting, till the end of the accounting year, some wages are still outstanding. So these are nothing but closing balance of wages outstanding. So closing balance of debtors are written towards the credit side. Quite obviously, closing balance of what we call salaries will be put towards the debit side. Not a very tough, but still actually I will do it for you. So first of all, let me prepare a branch account. This is branch account. Then I stretch a line and I think this much is enough. So besides that, we'll prepare debtors account also. Debtors account. So after having framed the balances, now all I need to do is to fill up this information, which is very simple. You can easily manage this question of your own. 1.22 is the one which we are picking up, 1.22. And now I start the solution. Opening stock, first I will write here opening balances. Opening balances brought down, opening stock. Opening stock given to us is 75,000. I will write here 75,000. Just let me adjust a wee bit. So 75,000 is the opening stock, correct? Then of course we will take the loading of this particular item. And in order to take the loading, I will write towards the opposite side, load on opening stock. Opening stock is 75,000. Rate of loading we have just found out, that is equal to 1/5. So 15,000 will be your loading amount. Loading amount will be equal to 15,000, isn't it or not? Next item is closing stock. So we move over to the what we call bottom of branch account towards the credit side. We write here balance carried down. And then I write here closing stock. Amount of closing stock given to us in this particular case is 90,000. So 90,000 I write, and then I will take the loading of this particular item also. I will write here load on closing stock. Load on closing stock 90,000 into 1 by 5. That is equal to 18,000. Then stock at the end, after that we have got opening and closing daters. So I will write here opening daters. Opening balance of daters is 42,000. I will write here 42. Closing balance of daters is 54. So I will write here 54,000. And of course we are preparing daters account. So in the daters account, I will write opening daters. Opening balance of daters was 42,000. And closing balance in the daters account was 54,000. This is how we have to move about as far as this question is concerned. Then goods invoiced from what we call head office. So towards the debit side of branch account, I will write to goods sent to branch account 5,46,000. And towards the opposite side, once again, I will write load on goods sent to branch account 5,46,000 into 1 by 5. So 1 by 5 of what we call 5,46,000, 5,46,000 divided by 5 is equal to 1,09,200. So 1,09,200 is your loading. Besides that, we have got rates and taxes, sundry expenses. So I will write here to bank or to cash. So head office must have sent cash for sundry expenses 4,800 and rates and taxes. Rates and taxes 24,000, correct? Then we have got in this case cash sales to the extent of 3,24,000. Sundry expenses are 4,800, rates and taxes 24, and cash sales are 3,24,000. So I will write here by remittances. By remittances. Under remittances, I'm going to write by cash sales 3,24,000. So 3,24,000 worth of sales you are going to put up over here. And then we have got in this particular case cash receipt from ledger. I just told you cash receipt from ledger is nothing but cash receipt from debtors. So cash from ledgers. Cash from ledgers given to you 1,98,000. Because you are preparing debtors account, correct? You are preparing debtors account also. So in the debtors account also, you are going to write cash from ledgers or cash from debtors. Cash from ledgers actually is 1,98,000. Then we have in this case credit sales to the extent of 2,10,000. So I will write here credit sales towards the debit side. Credit sales given to us in this particular question 2,10,000, not 2,10,000 actually. Credit sales is 2,10,000. And then we have got wages paid. So I will write here wages paid to cash. Wages. That is equal to 20,400. And then wages is still outstanding is basically closing balance of wages. That is liability. So wages outstanding or still owing means still we are supposed to pay it. So I will simply write it this way now, 2000. So this is how you are supposed to do this question. And in this question, your debtor's account is getting tallied of its own. And all you have to do is to find out the profit now and write it over there. So your net profit will be equal to 58,000. Simple question, not very tough. Net profit 58,000. Not a very tough question at all. Correct? Then we move. Just wait. Just wait. Give me 1 minute. Sometime, you know. Paper slides a wee bit. Okay, now it's okay. So the next question which we will pick up now. 1.23 states that Essex company has a branch at Delhi and goods are invoiced from head office at cost plus 33.13%. So 1.23 is the next one. Now, the very first thing in this particular question is rates analysis. Rate is given to you as cost plus 33.13%. So, cost price plus margin. Is equal to invoice price. Rate of profit is given on cost. Consider cost as 100. Margin is 33.13. Your invoice price will become 133.13. Ultimately, you will have to write in the numerator margin 33.13. In the denominator, you will write invoice price 133.13. Sometime back, I told you how to solve it, 33 into 399 plus 100 by 3. So this numerator term will be 100 by 3. And similarly, in the denominator, we have 133 1 by 3. So first I multiplied 133 with 3, that is 399 plus 1, 400. So it will be equal to 400 by 3. Ultimately, it will be equal to 100 by 3. Into 3 by 400. So that is equal to 1 by 4. That means your rate of loading on invoice price is equal to 1 by 4. This is the first thing which you need to do. Then in this question, we have been given opening debtors, opening balances. So opening balances of debtors, petty cash, furniture, stock. These are the opening balances given to us in this particular question. Quite obviously, towards the debit side of the branch account, I am going to write opening balances. Correct? Just wait. So, when I will prepare branch account in this particular question, branch account. But I am not having the space, so I will rub it up. So this is your branch account, correct? Branch account. Now similarly, you will have to prepare your branch debtors account. It's a formality, but you will have to do it. So this is your data account. You can start doing this question of your own because main point I have already explained, correct? So now in this particular question, what we are supposed to do? We have been given opening data, so as I told you. First of all, we will write simply opening balance brought down. Under the opening balances, I will write data's 10,000. So opening balance of data's is 10,000. Opening balance of petty cash is also given to you, 1,000. Besides that, you have been given in this particular question furniture. So I will simply write F oblique F for furniture, and I am going to write here 2,000. Then we have been given balance of stock, that is 8,000. After having noted them down, the next step is to write your opening balance of debtors in the debtors account first of all. So write here balance brought down 8,000. Balance brought down 8,000 you have written now. Similarly, you have to take the loading of opening stock. So you write here loading on opening stock. Loading on opening stock. Opening stock amount is 8,000. Rate of loading we just computed is equal to 1 by 4. So that will deliver you 2,000. Now we have cash sent by head office for petty expenses. So in the current year, head office must have sent some further cash to meet petty expenses. I will write here 2 cash. So cash for petty expenses if you want to mention. Cash for petty expenses. So head office has sent further cash, that is 2,000. Then we have branch expenses and losses. Branch expenses and losses, pay attention. Freight and advertisement. Freight and advertisement, I will write here 2 cash. And I will write here freight. So in order to meet this expense, head office must have sent the cash, freight and advertisement expenses, that is equal to 5,600. Next expense is bad debts. Now don't write here 2 cash. For bad debts, we never send cash. So bad debts have taken place. So bad debts will be written towards the credit side of your debtor's account. This is the transaction between what we call branch customer and branch account. So bad debts you are going to simply put towards the credit side. Bad debts happens to be 50. You are going to write here 50. Then you have depreciation. Similar to what we call bad debts, we cannot write here 2 cash depreciation. When I will write the closing balance, balance carried down. And over there, when I am going to write the balance of furniture, we had furniture in the beginning to the extent of 2,000. As you know, depreciation amount will be subtracted from it. So depreciation is 80. So closing balance of furniture now will be equal to 1920. This is how depreciation will be reflected. Then after that, we have been given petty expenses. Now petty expenses are met out of petty cash. So the treatment will be like this. I will write here petty cash. Opening balance of petty cash given in the question was 1,000. So branch had in the beginning with him in the form of petty cash 1,000. And in the current year, head office has sent further petty cash to the extent of, how much? 2,000, I think. 2,000. So head office has sent 2,000 more for petty expenses. So out of 3,000, petty expenses 1,500 have been incurred by branch manager. So 1,500 I am going to subtract, less 1,500. So closing balance of petty cash will be equal to 1,500. Correct? Petty expenses, depreciation, these are shown in an indirect manner. After that, we have got cash sales. I will write here remittances. In the remittances, I will write here cash sales. Amount of cash sales given to you is 50,000. You write here 50,000. Then we have credit sales. Kevin's credit sales will be written towards the debit side of branch debtors account, as you know. Amount of credit sales is 36,000. Then we have goods returned by debtors. When goods are returned by debtors, we put it towards the credit side of debtors account only. Goods return, also known as sales return or return inward. Goods returned by debtors is equal to 800. I will write here 800. Goods returned to branch, goods returned by branch to head office. Now this transaction is taking place between branch and head office. So first of all, I will write here goods sent to branch, returns. So branch has returned some goods to the extent of 2000. I will write here 2000. Of course, I will have to do the loading. I will write here goods sent to branch, returns, loading. And loading amount will be equal to 2000 into 1 by 4. That is equal to 500. That is equal to 500. Then we have cash receipt from debtors. So in this question, cash receipt from debtors is also given. You will write here cash receipt from debtors. Cash from debtors given to you is 20,000. And in the debtors account, you should not forget to write cash from debtors. Then stock at invoice price is given to you. Closing stock. Closing stock at the end is 7,800. You are going to write here 7,800. Of course, you will have to take the loading now. Load on closing stock. You can also write stock reserve closing. Instead of writing load on closing stock, you can simply write stock reserve. Anyway, so 7,800 into 1 by 4. 7,800 into 1 by 4 will be equal to 1950, I think. And then we have, in this case, goods invoiced by head office. That is given almost at the end. So, goods sent to branch account. I will write here now. Goods sent to branch account. 88,000 worth of goods have been sent. We will take the loading also. And I will write here load on. Goods sent to branch account. That is 88,000 into 1 by 4. So 22,000. This is how you will have to do. First you now tally your debtors account. In the debtors account, you will get the closing balance. Closing balance carried down. And closing balance will be equal to 25,150. Closing debtors, you must mention here also. Closing debtors. 25,150. And after that, you can find out your net profit. 13,320. Correct? So question was not tough, but in this question, I just wanted to give you an idea regarding what we call outstanding balance. Treatment of bad debts, etc. Sometimes student commit mistake by simply writing here two cash. So you have to be alert when question gives you information in such a manner. Question number 1.24 has struck in the examination and should not be a botheration, should not be a problem for you. 1.24 is the question. I will simply explain this question. You can do it by yourself. 1.24. Question says that XYZ company is having its branch at City X, correct? And goods are invoiced to the branch at 20% profit on sales. 20% profit on sales. Cost price plus margin is equal to invoice price or sale price. This time rate is given on sale price. Margin is 20. Cost will be 80. So your rate will be equal to 25 by 100 or 1 by 5. So opening stock 30,000 is given. And then you have sundry debtors, cash in hand, office furniture, goods invoiced from head office, goods returned to head office, goods returned by debtors, cash received from debtors, cash sales, credit sales, discount allowed to debtors, and these are the expenses for which head office has sent some cash. Correct, head office has sent cash, rent, salary, stationery and printing. And it is given petty expenses paid by branch. So from the opening cash in hand, you will subtract what we call 600 to get the closing balance of cash in hand. Not a very tough question. Correct? So you can easily manage. This is what I have explained here. Petty cash 800 was in the beginning and petty expenses equal to 600 you are going to subtract to get the answer. It is an easy question. Then we have 1.25. Local purchases by branch. What we mean by local purchases by branch? Generally, under data system, I have already told you, all the goods which are required by the branch are basically sent by the head office. That means branch hasn't got this much of liberty to purchase the goods of its own. However, in some rare exceptional circumstances, we may provide this right. We means the head office may provide actually some rights to our branch that, well, in case of need, you can purchase the goods from your local area. So that is what we mean by local purchases by branch. Indirectly, it means this time not only head office is sending the goods to the branch, but branch is also purchasing and procuring the goods in the nearby local area. Head office of company invoices goods to branch at cost plus 20%. Cost plus 20%, your rate will be cost 100, margin 20, and invoice price will be 120. So 20 by 120 will be your rate on invoice price. Then the branch expenses, branch purchases goods from the local parties also. However, whenever such rights are given to the branch, branch can only purchase the goods, but the payment ultimately will be done by head office. The branch purchases goods from the local party also, for which the payments are made by the head office. So head office actually will make the payment. All cash collected by the branch is banked on the same day to the credit of the head office account, correct? And all expenses are paid directly by the head office except the petty expenses, as petty cash is maintained by the branch office. From the following information, show the branch account. So how branch account will appear in this particular case? We have been given impressed cash in the beginning. Impressed cash in the beginning means fixed amount of cash in the beginning, 2000 has been kept. In simple word, opening balance of petty cash is 2000. Closing balance is also given to you. Debtors on the first day of the accounting year. Debtors on the first day of the accounting year means opening debtors. Stock in the beginning. Now, stock in the beginning, this is the line you need to understand. Opening stock in the beginning transferred from head office. So last year head office might have sent some goods to branch, and out of those goods, some of the goods might not have been sold out. So it was closing stock till the end of the last year. Now it will be considered as opening stock. That means this opening stock is out of the goods which have been transferred by head office. However, there is also opening stock out of goods which have been purchased by branch, because in this question branch is also making some purchases. So branch might have made some purchases, and out of those goods, some of the goods might have remained unsold. So this is opening stock out of those goods. Now you are not going to take the loading of such goods which have been purchased by branch. Are you getting my point or not? Because loading will be done only with respect to such goods which have been sent by head office, because head office is sending those goods at a price bit higher than their cost price. Cash sales 45, credit sales 130. Direct purchases made by the branch, so you will simply write to bank towards the debit side of the branch account. Goods returned by the customer will find place in the debtor's account. Goods sent to branch office from head office at invoice price is 60,000. Cash transferred from head office to branch for petty expenses, so this year head office has also sent some petty cash. Then bad debts is equal to 1,000. And besides that, discount allowed is 2,000. Cash received from customer 1,25,000. Branch expenses 30,000. And stock at the end, again it is given to you that whatever stock is there at the end, some of the stock is out of the goods which have been sent by head office, and some of the closing stock is there, which out of those goods which have been actually purchased by the branch only. So now I will prepare the branch account, correct, to solve this question. Branch account. Correct. And this is a question number 1.25. In this particular question, first of all, we begin with opening balances brought down. So impressed cash, that is cash in the beginning, fixed amount of cash in the beginning is 2,000. I will write here 2,000. And at the end also is given. So I will write here balance carried down. So fixed cash at the end of the year given to you is 1,850. 1,850. Then we have been given debtors, so I will write opening debtors. Amount of debtors is equal to 25,000, so I will write here 25,000. Because debtors balance is given, I will have to prepare debtor account also. And in the debtors account, I will write balance brought down 25,000. Correct? After that, we have in this case stock in the beginning. Now, stock in the beginning is this. This is important line. Stock in the beginning, I will write here first of all opening stock. And then transferred from head office. So this is opening stock of such goods which have been transferred by head office, to transferred from head office, opening stock 24,000. These goods have been transferred by head office, that means these goods are at invoice price, so I will have to take the loading also. Towards the opposite side, I will write here load on opening stock. So 24,000 into 1/6. On these goods, I will have to take the loading. Reason being is that these goods are at invoice price. However, in this particular case, when I will write opening stock out of direct purchases, Direct purchases means these goods have been directly purchased by the branch of it itself. So opening stock out of direct purchases need not require any loading. That is the point which you need to understand. Then cash sales is given to us. Cash sales actually is 45,000, as you can see. So I'm going to write here remittances. I will write here cash sales. Amount of cash sales which is given to us is 45,000. Then we have been given credit sales. Need not require to tell you where I will write credit sales. 1,30,000. Besides that, we have in this case direct purchases made by branch. Direct purchases made by branch. We have already seen that even though branch has been given liberty to purchase the goods out of the local market, but the payment ultimately will be done by head office. So that's the reason I will write here to bank. It means head office must have sent money to purchase these goods. Direct purchases. Direct purchases by branch, and branch has made direct purchases of 45,000. No question of any loading because these goods are being purchased by branch. Goods returned by customers will be written in the debtors accounts. Goods returned by customers. And it is equal to 3,000, no question of any loading on these goods. Goods sent to branch. Now, in the current year, goods have been sent by head office to the branch. So we will write here two goods sent to branch account. 60,000 worth of goods have been sent. And we will take the loading now. We will write towards the opposite side, load on goods sent to branch account. 60,000 into 1/6. That is equal to 10,000. So 10,000 worth of loading we shall also write in this case. Then we have in this particular question, bad debt. Before that, we have cash transferred from head office to branch for petty expenses. So I am simply going to write here to cash or bank. So head office has transferred petty cash, transfer for petty cash. So head office has transferred for petty cash further amount, and this is equal to how much? That is 2,500. 2,500. Is it clear to you? And then we have got in this particular case bad debts. Bad debts will be written in debtors account only. Amount of bad debts is 1,000. You will write here. Then we have discount also. So discount will also find place over here. Amount of discount in this case is 2,000. You will write here 2,000. Then cash receipt from customer is also given. Cash receipt from customer also finds place in the debtors account. Cash from debtors or customers, one and same thing. 1,25,000. And you will write it under remittances also. So cash from customers or debtors. One lakh 25,000. Then in this particular question, we have branch expenses. Branch expenses are 30,000. Obviously, for branch expenses, cash will be sent by head office to cash. Branch expenses 30,000. Then we have been given closing stock. We will write here closing stop. So again, closing stock transferred from head office. So closing stock out of those goods which have been transferred by head office is actually equal to 18,000. So I will have to take the loading of this one. I will write here load on closing stock 18,000 into 1/6. That is equal to 3,000. That is equal to 3,000, correct? Now, besides that, we have in this case closing stock out of direct purchases. Direct purchases. Out of direct purchases, that is 12,000. No question of any loading with respect to this one. So this is how you are going to do this question. Now you will compute the closing balance of debtor's account. And closing balance of debtor's account will be balance carried down, balancing figure, and it will be equal to 24,000. 24,000. You will write closing balance of debtors over here. That is equal to 24,000. And then finally, you are going to find out your net profit. And your net profit will be, or should be, should I say, because I haven't computed it. You compute it by yourself. Should be equal to 32,350. Should be equal to this much. So this was the question, pretty what we call different from the other one. So you have to take care of local purchases. Question number 1.26, what does it states? F1 and Company of Delhi has a branch at Jaipur and goods are invoiced to the branch at cost plus 25%. No problem here. Further, question states that all the expenses are paid through check by head office except petty expenses which are paid by the branch. It's normal thing. Now, in this question, opening and closing stock is given. You can easily manage this. Opening and closing debtors is also given. Furniture and fixture opening balance is also given. Cash sales is also given. Credit sales is given. Goods invoiced from head office. Expenses paid by head office. Petty expenses paid by branch. You will subtract the petty expenses from the opening balance of the petty cash. But the problem is that in this particular question, there is no opening balance of petty cash. So then what will you do? There are two possibilities in this case with respect to petty expenses because you are not having any opening balance. What I mean to say is, in this particular question, we are not having any opening balance of petty cash. Petty cash balance is zero. And there are some petty expenses, and petty expenses must be met by branch. Question is very clearly stated there. If you are not having petty cash, never commit this mistake by writing it this way. Don't write it this way. Petty cash, opening balance nil, less petty expenses. Because normally we subtract petty expenses from petty cash. And don't write as negative item, minus 20,900. Don't do this mistake, correct? You should not present it this way. You are not having opening balance of petty cash. But you were supposed to actually, if you had petty cash opening balance, then in that case, you would have had subtracted it from the what we call petty cash balance. Since in this question, there is no petty cash balance, the better treatment is that when you will write the remittances, just allow me. So, in this particular question, when you will write the remittances later on, we know that under remittances, we write cash sales. Whatever cash sales are there, you write over here. Then we write cash from debtors. Cash from debtors. Correct? Now you subtract petty expenses from here. Because ultimately, petty expenses must be borne by the head office. That's a different matter. If we are having petty cash as opening balance, then we subtract it out of that. Remember, even whatever petty cash you are having at your disposal, that was also sent to you by the head office. Ultimately, it means the petty expenses are borne by the head office. Number one. Because in this question, head office hasn't what we call kept any petty cash with the branch manager. So what you are going to do is that because this is the amount which you means the branch is supposed to pay to the head office. So you will subtract the petty cash expenses from this amount. From this amount, you will subtract the petty cash expenses. Is it clear to you in this particular question as I have done it? And later on, it is also given in this question, furniture was acquired by branch. Furniture was acquired by branch on 1/10/2018. Correct? Your current accounting year is starting on 1/4/2018 and it is ending on 31/3/2019. Current accounting year is starting from 1/4/2018. And it is ending on 31/3/2019. And in between, on 1st of October, that means midway, 1st of October 2018, actually branch purchased a furniture. Branch purchased a furniture. Sometime what happened, branch may be in need of, or branch might feel the need to have a some furniture or some asset. So they can take the permission from the head office. Well, we need actually this item. Please allow us to purchase it. So head office will tell them, okay, you go ahead, you purchase this item. But logically, branch has purchased it, but ultimate responsibility to bear the expenses in respect of this particular asset will lie upon the shoulders of what we call head office. So what will be the treatment now? Whenever branch will purchase any asset, of course, branch cannot purchase any asset unless and until it has taken prior sanction from the head office. So we shall always presume that it is given to us in the question that branch has purchased, so we must have had taken the permission. Number one. Number two. Now we have purchased the asset. Ultimately, we have to take back this money from the head office. We are the branch. We have purchased the furniture. We have to now take the refund from the branch. So instead of taking the refund, what I will do, I will subtract it from remittances. Correct? I will subtract it from remittances and I will write here purchase of furniture. So I have purchased furniture to the extent of 5,000. I will subtract it. Similarly, with respect to what we call petty expenses, whatever petty expenses were there, whatever petty expenses were there, 20,900, I am going to subtract this also from the total remittances. Is it clear to you or not? Second treatment with respect to furniture will be when you will write the closing balance carried down. In the branch account, when you will write the closing balance. So here also you will have to exercise caution with respect to furniture. You had in the beginning furniture worth rupees 46,800. You had furniture 46,800 and you have acquired furniture in the current years. So closing balance of furniture will also go up by 5,000. So total furniture at your disposal at the end is 51,800, but 51,800. But you will have to now provide depreciation on it also because there is some depreciation in the question. Question has stated that depreciation on furniture and fixtures will be provided at the rate of 10% on written down value basis. So, depreciation when I'm going to provide on 46,800, depreciation will be at the rate of 10%, that is equal to 4,680. 4,680 will be the amount of furniture depreciation, and the furniture which I have acquired in the current year, I will write depreciation but only for 6 months because we purchased this furniture on 1/10/2018. So from this date onward till the what we call end of the current accounting year, that is 6 months, we will have to compute the depreciation on it. So depreciation will be equal to 250. So total depreciation will be equal to this much. That is equal to 4680 plus 250, and 4930 will be your total depreciation. So closing balance, which you are going to write, furniture 46,800 plus purchases 51,800 minus this. So 46,800 plus 5,000 minus 4930. 46,870. 46,870. This is how you are going to present this item. So these are the vital points of this particular question. Correct? I have explained 3 points here, and rest of the things you can easily manage it by yourself. See here. This is cash sale, cash from debtors, and less furniture acquired, 5,000 I have subtracted. Petty expenses I have subtracted, so net remittances will be this much. And secondly, when I will write furniture, I will write it this in this manner, opening balance plus acquired by branch and total depreciation. I showed you how 4930 and net balance is this much. I hope now you can actually do this question of your own 1.26. Then similarly, we have next 1.27. First, you try to do it off yourself, and then later on, we will see to it whether you have done it or not in the next session. So till then, it's time to say goodbye.